Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is the fourth Sunday of Advent, December 18th, 2016. Today, during the middle of the service, the choir will have the cantata. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Telephone number is 937-323-7508.
Rejoice, rejoice, believers. We're rejoicing because Jesus Christ is coming into the world. This is the fourth Sunday of Advent, St. John's Lutheran Church. You'll be honored to hear the cantata sung by our choir today. This hymn is Rejoice, Rejoice, Believers.
Thank you. you.
Gus and Condi Singleton will be lighting the Advent wreath today.
The fourth Sunday of Advent, we have the lighting of the four candles, the three purple candles, and one pink candle. We're lighting candles to welcome Messiah. This is the fourth Sunday of Advent, and this week is Christmas Eve. Welcome Jesus Christ, who's born into the world as the Savior, the Son of God, the incarnate Son of God, born of Virgin Mary.
Steve Clark will be doing the readings today.
First reading for today is from the 7th chapter of Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask a sign of the Lord your God. Let it be deep as Sheol or as high as heaven." But Ahaz said, "I will not ask. I will not put the Lord to test." And Isaiah said, "Hear then, O house of David. Is it too little for you to weary mortals that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child and shall bear a son, shall name him Emmanuel. He shall eat curds and honey by the time he knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good. But before the child knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good, the land before whose two kings you are in bread will be served. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Dennis Ross, for the song.
Reading the Gospel.
Joseph awoke from sleep. He did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had born a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated. A couple of announcements to share with you. First of all, as some of you are aware, we lost our brother Ben Blades from the Church Militant to the Church Triumphant on Friday. The funeral will be Wednesday, December 21st at 11 o'clock here in the sanctuary. There will be a time to greet the family from 10 to 11, in the sanctuary before the service. And then immediately following the worship service, or the funeral service, there will be a meal downstairs. The internment will be just the family and myself before the visitation. So we will be out at Ferncliff like at 9 for the committal and interment of the ashes. Then they will come here at 10, come upstairs here to greet Carol and her daughter Jane and her family. And then at 11 o'clock we will begin this celebration of Ben's life. Also, Saturday, of course, as you well know, is Christmas Eve. Services will be at 6 and 9:30. Christmas Day, one service at 10 o'clock. Also, New Year's Day, one service at 10 o'clock. So please make note of that and join us as we celebrate the birth of our Lord and the new secular year calendar the following week. Now I'd ask that you give your attention.
Appeared and said, "Dear John, behold, I bring you tidings of great joy. his star in the east and have come to worship him.
Oh, Those who can, please rise. Please join me with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified upon Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray. As we await the coming of our Savior in mercy and majesty, let us pray through his Father for the Church, the world, and for all people according to their need. Our response today is, hear our prayer. O wisdom, proceeding from the mouth of the Most High, fill the Church with your Spirit. Sustain and order its proclamation and its works of charity, especially in the presence of its enemies. According to your most holy will, come and teach us prudence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Adam, ruler of the house of Israel, rule also in the hearts, lives, and ministries of your people in this congregation. Give us your word, and show us your glory. Look with favor upon our sister congregations and compassion synods and your missionaries around the world. Come with your outreached arm to redeem us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Emmanuel, the ransom of your people Israel, deliver also your persecuted church from the captivity of torment. Keep it patient, faithful, and steadfast. Help us to honor their witness and provide for their needs, and turn their tormentors from their evil ways. Come and teach them courage. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O bright and morning star, you gladden the hearts of those who sit in darkness. Shine on all who are overwhelmed by grief, despair, doubt, anger, confusion, hatred, or unbelief. Come and lead them into the brightness of your holy love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O King of the nations and ruler that they long for, unite all people under your glorious and gentle reign. Teach us those things that make for peace. Come and save us all, whom you formed out of clay. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O root of Jesse, you stand as an ensign before the people. Guard and guide all who stand in harm's way in defense of justice and freedom. Come quickly and deliver them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O dayspring, splendor of life everlasting, keep safe in your mighty arms all those who die, trusting in your promises. Come and enlighten them among us who still sit in the shadows of death, and open wide our heavenly home. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, merciful Father, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Time for our offering. Our ushers are Gus and Connie Singleton. They also lit the Advent wreath today. This is the fourth Sunday of Advent, 18th of December, and Christmas Eve is coming upon us. Christmas Eve is Saturday night, and then Sunday is the 25th. We celebrate the worship of the newborn King. Jesus Christ is born to save us. Emmanuel, God with us. We are together. We are one. We're not separated from God. He is with us. He lives on earth with us in the beginning. And he's the beginning and the end, and the giver of life. Blessed, he is blessed before the birth of creation. He was born in the city of David. Christ the Lord, Christmas Eve. The flowers today are presented today in memory of Elmer Kramer, by Sandy Kramer. Elmer Kramer is Sandy Kramer's mother. Also, the flowers on the chancel stand are given to the glory of God, anonymous to the glory of God. We praise God for all he's done for us, especially for coming into the world. He's born Emmanuel, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. We worship him today. We also receive him as he ascended to heaven, but after that, he had the Holy Spirit descended to us, and he has left us to receive him in the body and blood. We believe in the real presence. Jesus is with us forever and ever. He's never left us, and he never will, and he will come back to look for his second coming. We invite you to come Christmas Eve, worship with us any Lord's Day. Worshiping on Christmas Day at 10 o'clock, we usually worship at 10:30 on Sundays.
Let us pray. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and food from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence, in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
St. John practices an open communion. For all those who are baptized and believe in Jesus Christ as a personal Lord and Savior, we believe his body and blood are truly present as we gather this table in our communion age and own individual congregation. You're invited and encouraged to come forward with us this day as we gather at the table of our Lord. Continue our celebration with a great thanksgiving on page 6 in your bulletin. The Lord be with you. in the law. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night when he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, Higher of the Most High, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
have now received the sacred mystery, the body and the blood, the true body and blood, real presence of Jesus Christ within us. As he was born incarnate, Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, we're celebrating that this Saturday night, the 24th of December. We received him now in Holy Communion, and he lives within us as he is present, the living God. Hymn, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, is a Latin hymn from the 9th century. During that time in the 9th century, hymns were sung from December the 17th to December 23rd. Each hymn had to start with O, and this was a hymn that was O Come, Emmanuel. There were other hymns too, but these are called the word O. It was translated by John M. Neal, who liked traditional hymns. He didn't like the hymns that were written by Isaac Watts, so he translated a lot of traditional hymns. O come, Emmanuel. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel.
Thank you. serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for worshiping with us as you're watching our service on YouTube. This is the fourth Sunday of Advent, December the 18th, 2016, St. John's Lutheran Church. We invite you to listen anytime to our services on YouTube, and we invite you to come to us. Come worship with us, 8:30 and 10:30, 8:30 and 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock service every Sunday, 10:30 service every Sunday, and 6:30 in the chapel. We receive Holy Communion. Thank you for worshiping with us. Tune in anytime. We're happy to bring you this service. Our church offers a Christian school if we can get it started again. We may try to unite with some of the other Lutheran churches. We need to get our Christian school started again. Thank you for joining us in our worship this Lord's Day. I hope and I pray that God will continue to bless and keep you this day and all your days. We will pray for you. Continue to pray for us. Our last hymn, O Come Emmanuel, was written in the 800s. It's a 9th century Latin hymn, This is how long this hymn has been sung, O Come Emmanuel. And looking forward to Jesus' birth, asking Jesus to come to us as he came as a newborn baby, 24th of December, Christmas Eve, and he's with us forever. As we receive him in Holy Communion, we have him in our hearts. We say, Lord Jesus, make him. And you can be Lord of our lives. Come into our hearts, Lord Jesus. All we have to do is say that one prayer. And Jesus is with us. And he will come again. This is Advent. We're acknowledging Jesus' birth. And we're looking forward to his coming again. As he loves us, wants to be with us, God with us, Emmanuel.